Hi, this is JP from Not the Lights Over Arkham. Welcome to the Sinister Motives expansion playthroughs, and we are starting from the first scenario of Sandman. We are playing the Ghost Spider or Gwen Stacy for this first playthrough. Throughout this series, I will be altering with the two heroes that come in the box. So first we are playing with the Ghost Spider. The second scenario, I will be playing Spider-Man Miles Morales. And so forth, so we'll alternate between those two. And I am playing on standard difficulty and true solo, so depending on how the encounter deck handles, this might be short games, because a couple of the first scenarios have a really low threshold and only one main scheme. So if we luck out and draw advances a lot, especially with Ghost Spider, we might just tread out. But we'll do our best, and without further delay, let's get started. We are ready to begin. So, I am not playing these scenarios in campaign mode. We are just playing them as standalone, so no campaign mode added cards used or any upgrades to the decks in between scenarios. I'm using the pre-built decks from the box, so we are in protection aspect with the Ghost Spider, so let's draw our opening hand. Well, actually, let's first look at Sandman. So Sandman has the Sandblast Force Interrupt. When Sandman attacks, that attack deals indirect damage. If your identity takes any amount of damage from that attack, resolve the Searching Sand's ability on city streets. Searching Sands is place one sand counter here. Discard cards from the top of the encounter deck equal to the number of sand counters here. And hero action, exhaust a character you control. Remove sand counters from here equal to that character's attack. Limit once per round per player. So we need to get rid of these sand counters, because every time this resolves, we lose cards from here. That is not that bad at first, but during the game we are rotating this encounter deck through many times and getting a lot of acceleration tokens, which will make this harder the further this takes. So we aim to defeat Sandman as fast as possible and keep the sand counters in check, and also mind the threat here. So we'll draw our opening hand, and let's see, we get Genius, return a favor, bait and switch, web binding, and young love. Well, I think we won't be needing these at the start. Web binding we could save for the bait and switch. So we could actually bait and switch. Well, it's not that good at the start. Well, we'll mulligan those two. Keep the return. Well, actually, I think we can the return of favors both, and I'm getting rid of the bait and switch. Might be a mistake, but it is what it is. So we draw two cards, we get another bait and switch, and plan B. Okay, well, I think we can do something with this. Gwen Stacy has the action: choose to either shuffle Ticket to the Multiverse from your discard pile into your deck, or ready Judge Stacy, limit once per round. So if we get Ticket to the Multiverse, we can get it back into the deck and get it as a double wild resource. Okay, let's see what we can do here. This we are saving to the for the bait and switch possibly. So we'll go to hero mode. I think I'll play the plan B with one of the return of favors to build up Then I will. I'll actually use the bait and switch to play plan B. Then we will. Let's return a favor here. So discard cards from here until we hit a treachery. Not a treachery. So sand slide. When revealed, place two sand counters on city streets, then resolve its searching sand's ability. If that is one sandman card was discarded this way, you are stunned. That is not really nice. So we have to reveal that, so we add here, discard six cards. Let's see. Place two sand counters on scissors, then resolve with searching sand's ability. If at least one sandman card was discarded, let's see. Place one sand counter here, so we get another sand counter here. So this might be a mistake right from the get go, but it is what it is. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And there are some sandman cards here, so that means we are stunned. And because we are stunned, this, I think this attack cancels. Because we just remove the stun token. I think that is how it works. Well, that was not nice at all. I think we have to do something to the sand counter, so I'm just removing two. And we don't even want to use the plan B here. So that was a pretty useless turn for us. We're ready, we draw back up to five. Jump, flip and silk, really good. We'll go to the villain phase, we add one threat to the main scheme. Sandman attacks, I will defend. 2 plus 1 is 3, so I will actually play the web. No, I'll save the web binding. I'll play jump flip using the return of favor, just so that we use a jump flip will prevent two of the damage. We don't take any, but this is more important. If you play this card using our energy resource, remove two threat from the main scheme, so that is more important here. And be ready, because we played interrupt. We got an encounter card, and it is Tidal Sands. When we will place X additional threat here, where X is equal to the number of sands counters on city streets, so that is tough. We add 5 plus 2, so this is really hard to get rid of now. But that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. This turn we don't have that much to play, but at least I can web binding for the plan B. So we use genius to play silk. So after you play silk from your hand, if you control another web warrior, which goes through spider east, search encounter deck for a treachery and discard it. And we will definitely discard Shadows of the Past. We don't want the lizard to bring the healing factor to this game for the villain, at least not soon in soon. So that is done. Then I will just remove two from here. Silk will thwart for one. And we will discard a random card, which is this, with plan B to deal two damage here. That is all we can do. We ready up. We draw back up to five. We get the phantom clip. Spider-Man, return the favor, ghost kick and jump flip. So pretty good defensive hand for the next villain phase and next round 2. So we go to the villain phase, we add one threat here. And Sandman attacks, I will defend with Ghost Spider. 2 plus 1, again we don't take any damage, but we will use the return favor to play jump flip, so we're ready. And remove 2 threats from the main scheme. And we get an encounter card, it is now or never. Peril, when revealed, choose, place one acceleration token on the main scheme, exhaust the character you control and spend one resource. Any type, I think I will... I think I have to exhaust the character I control and spend one resource of any type, so... I think I will remove. Spider-Man, yeah. So I'll spend that resource. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. This turn we don't have much to do, so I will just remove 2 sand counters from here. Oh, yeah, Silk should have readied. And I think I'm just keeping Silk around, so we will discard 1 card at random. So we lose Phantom Flip. Okay, well. Oh yeah, I forgot this last turn, so we get another card. So we got a Sand Clone also. So instead of removing these, I think I have to deal with the Sand Clone. So, let's back up. So, actually we could remove these. Then we plan B, so we are not dealing damage here, we deal it here. And Silk will defeat this. And when defeated, resolve the Searching Sands ability on City Street, so we add 1 here. We'll discard 2 cards. And that is it. Silk was also defeated. We keep the Ghost Kick. We are ready. We draw back up to... Oh yeah, this is exhaust, but ready. So we draw back up to 5. What doesn't kill me? Spider-Man, Miles Morales, Strength, and Ticket to the Multiverse and Ghost Kick. So really hoping to be able to do something next turn. Okay, we'll go to the villain phase. We add 1 threat here. Sandman attacks, I have to defend. 2 plus 1. Okay, so we take 1 damage. And then we have to resolve this, so we add 1 here. Discard 3, 1, 2, 3. And we get 2 encounter cards. Assault, Sandman attacks. We can't do anything. That. So 2 plus 1 is 3. We add another counter here. Discard 4, 1, 2, acceleration token. And that is it. And we still have the advance. So quick shuffle to the encounter deck. So this is how fast the encounter deck will rotate. If the Searching Sands is not dealt with. And even though we got rid of the shadows from the past, it's now back in here. So advance, 1 plus 1, so 2, threat to the main scheme. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. First off, I think we will play Strength. I will use, what doesn't kill me, so heal 2 damage, ready your hero, and then I will now I will use I will attack for two. I'll use Ticket to the Multiverse to play Ghost Kick to deal 6 damage here. And I will use Plan B to discard a random card, which is Spider-Man Miles Morales, to deal another 2 here. So Sandman is down to 4, and that is all we can do. We are ready. 2, 3, 4, 5. He gets across the Spider-Verse, Web of Life and Destiny, Ghost Kick, Spider-Man UK, and George Stacy. So, another Ghost Kick, so, well, unfortunately we don't have a way to ready, but we'll think of something else, so, go to the villain phase, we add 2 threat here, really need to get some threat removed soon. We'll defend, Sandman hits for 2 plus 0, we don't take any damage, we get 2 encounter cards, and Sandstorm, deal X indirect damage amongst players. Divided as you choose, where X is equal to the number of sun counters on city streets. If there are no sun counters, place 3 sun counters and shuffle this in the encounter deck. So we have to take 4, because that just happened. And then we get a sand clone. So, not looking really good, but we'll see what we can do. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. This turn... I think we can't play the Ghost Kick, so we can put the Web of Life and Destiny into play without paying its cost, because we have a Web Warrior here. Then we'll play Across the Spider-Verse, so exhaust the Web Warrior card you control. Set your discard pile for a Web Warrior ally and put it into play, then choose a player. That player may spend well. I could choose myself, but I don't have the resources to do that, but we'll put these two here. Let's see. Okay, so after I put, so I have 3 Web Warrior cards. So I'll put Miles Morales into play, paying those two. Keeping the Ghost Kick. So I'll stun and confuse Sandman. Then I will thwart for 1. Just try and at least do something. And I'll just discard this for the Plan B. Deal 2. Actually, yeah, we have the Sand Claw. Yeah, well, let's forget about that. So I'll actually cancel the ward here. So I'll hit for 2, deal 2 here, and we'll add 1 counter here. Discard 5 cards. 5. At least we got rid of the Shadows of the Past. And I think I'll stay in hero mode for 1 more turn, so we don't lose to a bad timed advance. So we're ready. We draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We get Web Binding, Phantom Flip, Web Bracelet, What Doesn't Kill Me, and Energy. So at least we have a way to heal and ready next turn. So we go to the villain phase, we have 2 threats here. We are 2 away from losing. Sandman tries to attack, but it's stunned, so we remove the stun. We get 2 encounter cards. First is Calling in Favors, Rhino Schemes. Well, if Rhino is not in play, search the encounter deck and discard pile for Rhino minion. Put him into play, engage with you. We'll do that. Here is Rhino. Rhino has steadied, so we need 2 stuns and 2 confuses to stun or confuse Rhino. Then we shuffle the encounter deck. Then we get Sand Form attached to Sandman. Force interrupt when you deal any amount of damage to Sandman, discard. Okay, yeah. Oh yeah, and I forgot to add these here from the plan B. Okay, so Sand Form it is, and let's read it again. So when you would deal any amount of damage on to Sandman, discard Sand Form instead, result a surging Sand's ability on streets. And that is all, so that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Now we definitely need to play the Phantom Flip somehow. So let's see. I think we just go to Alter Ego this round to avoid Rhino. I'll attack for we remove this. We resolve the Searching Sands. Six cards. And then we'll use energy to play Phantom Flip. Be ready. So we remove five from here. And Miles Morales could hit Rhino for 2. Sandman for 2. Then I'll use these 2 to play. I'll remove 2 from here. I'll play What Doesn't Kill Me, heal 2. Ready. Then I will go to Alter Ego, heal for 3, nearly at full, and I'll shuffle the ticket to the multiverse back to the deck with Gwen Stacy's ability. And I think that is everything, so one consequential damage here. Okay, so that is everything we can do. We ready up, we draw back up to 6. We get another plan B. Parental Guidance to get to the multiverse, Phantom Flip, plan B, and Pirouette the Punch. So nothing we can do in the Alter Ego with these cards. The villain phase, but it is what it is. So we'll go to the villain phase. We have 2 threats here. Sandman is confused, so we remove the confused. Rhino skins for 0, and then we get 2 cards, so Dirt Trap can't remove threat from the main scheme. It has 1, so we can easily get rid of that. And when defeated, we resolve the Search and Sands. And then another Sand Form. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. We'll use both of the plan Bs to play, and this to play Ticket to the Multiverse. So shuffle your, now remove this from the game, shuffle your discard pile into your deck and draw up to your hand size, and ready each Ghost Spider card you control. Well, see. Before that we'll use this to remove 2, and it doesn't cause anything. Then before that we'll actually heal. So we're at full. We'll go to hero form. Then we'll play this. So this is removed from the game. We'll keep this and draw back. We'll shuffle everything. So we'll do a quick shuffle for our draw deck. Then we ready each character we control, or wet warrior card we control. We really want to defeat Rhino now, so hopefully drawing some attack cards. Okay, well, not such luck. We can combine attack and deal 6, I think. We could play across the map. Oh yeah, we don't have any allies. Well, we could put Spider-Man. Yeah, so we'll hit for 2. Well, Morales is defeated. We'll play this using bait and switch and one of the pirouette punches. And yeah, we draw a card with the Web of Life and Destiny. So we'll use this to play Miles Morales again. And I control now 3 Web Warrior cards. So we'll stun and confuse Sandman. We will hit for 2 here. Play Phantom Flip. Remove 5 from here. Ready. Then we need to deal 4 to Rhino, so both of these will defeat Rhino. And that is everything we can do, so we ready up. Draw back up to 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We get Strength, Energy, Ghost Kick, and Bait and Switch. So next turn, we definitely want to double Ghost Kick Rhino. Sandman. Okay, so we'll go to the villain phase. We have to prep the main scheme if we survive there. So we remove the stunt. We get 2 encounter cards. First is another dirt trap. So we'll try to burst down, and then we get panic on the street. So we don't have any personal supports or others. So let's see. Okay, so panic in the streets. Treat the printed text box of each location support and each personal support as if it were blank, except for traits. And this gives an acceleration token. So getting clutch here. Okay. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Let's see. I think we will attack with Ghost Spider. Remove Shifting Sands, we'll add 1 here. We remove Sand Form, then we discard 3. We get another acceleration token. We are losing if we go to the villain phase, but that is, well, if we lose, we lose. We'll just see how far we can go. Actually, let's back up. So, Spider-Man dust 2. Because we need to do this in a bit of a different order. Okay, now we will hit for 2. I'll use energy to play Ghost Kick. So, first off, we'll do this. So, when revealed, the result of searching sense ability is 3. So, we'll add 1 here. Discard 4. 1, 2, 4. And Sandman has 18 health, so unfortunately we are not able to defeat Sandman, but we have no ways to remove threat from here now. Which is a shame, but we are going to get close. So we hit for 6 damage with Ghost Kick, so we are at 12. Then we ready, we'll hit again for 2. We'll use Strength to play another Ghost Kick for 6 damage. Actually, we are 2 damage away from defeating Sandman. Okay. Then we plan B2. And we only can ready once during a phase, so we can't ready before we go to the villain phase. Well, that is a shame. We are 2 damage away from defeating Sandman, but we came pretty close, and I think we'll just play it out, so be ready up. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Silk, jump flip, young love, what doesn't kill me times 2, so we'll add 4 threat to the main scheme. So unfortunately that means we lose by threatening out. And that is the first scenario of the Sinister Motives expansion, and it is the Sandman. This is a pretty tough scenario, at least with the Ghost Spider in True Solo. I have played this with both of the decks as a two-player game, and because the other deck is Justice and Miles Morales, that deck can really handle all the threats going out on in this scenario. So if you are playing this two-handed, for example, I think this should be a pretty simple scenario to beat. But as usual, when playing through solo, even the simplest of scenarios might be a bit difficult if you can't handle the threat. And with protection, the threat handling is not the main focus of the deck, so that is that. So hope you guys like this playthrough and got some good information on how this scenario functions. Thanks for watching, and until next time.